The forensic science program at Syracuse University, we believe, is unique nationally, and we really have three parts of our mission and goal. One is to provide national leadership in forensic science. A very important second one is to provide the highest quality of graduate and undergraduate training for professionals going out in the field, and also to perform groundbreaking research.
Most of the successes that we have in national security from a U.S. perspective and working with our close allies are driven to some large extent by hard science and forensics, and the demand signal for people with expertise in that area is far stronger than a lot of people realize.
You're going to get the opportunity to participate in experiments and laboratory exercises that you normally would not have the opportunity to do outside of an actual crime lab.
I think the benefit of this program is that it's taught by a lot of practitioners in the field of forensic science.
This provides our students with firsthand knowledge of what it's like to be in the field, up-to-date information. They're creating networks from the time that they start the course.
If you decide you want to go into this field, you know, you can't just say, I want to be a forensic scientist. You have to say, I'm interested in ballistics, or I'm interested in fingerprints, or I'm interested in toxicology or DNA. There's a wide range of different people and classes that are taught here that give the students exposure to so many different disciplines that they can maybe find their way and decide what interests them the most.
One of the things that's unique about the firearms 1 and 2 courses here offered at Syracuse University is that we have an opportunity for our students to get hands-on with firearms and firearms-related evidence, which is going to be important because many of the positions in a laboratory require you to handle firearms and firearms-related evidence.
The Introduction to Lay and Prints course is a foundational course that I model around a lot of the training workshops I've attended professionally. One of the things I try to do is to integrate a lot of the more cutting-edge research, current developments within the field, things that are going on nationally and internationally within the latent print discipline, so that they'll be well-versed as far as what's actually taking place when they go out into the workforce.
The course that I am teaching is medical legal death investigation. The course really is focused on giving students a basic understanding of why we're doing what we're doing and the science behind what we're doing, then takes that information and asks them to apply it to either mock scenes or real life type experiences. Students really enjoy not only getting the theory, but applying that theory. Both locally and on a national level, the need for trained medical legal death investigators is growing.
Many of our students have actually gone on, and because of their experiences, it's put them in a very good position to be competitive for careers in this field.
I've had students who have talked to me and told me that through my class they've actually felt like they were a leg ahead of some of the other students once they've gotten to the position where they're headed. So I think it really just sets a really strong foundation.
I was interested in a branch of forensic science that isn't the traditional branch of DNA analysis or latent print examination. I wanted to do forensic linguistics, and Syracuse allowed me to build my own concentration within the forensic science department with the general track.
It is a very flexible program, and if someone is not too sure what they want to concentrate in, we have so many different classes, toxicology, latent prints, a multitude of classes.
My best advice would be just to find out what makes you enthusiastic about forensic science, whether it's the crime solving or just solving puzzles in general, and explore, look into different branches of the science. There are a lot of opportunities and a lot of options for every discipline to go into forensics.